One of my big, big things is integrity. I will not hire a team member who cannot use that term and look me in the eyes. I will not work for a customer who does not speak that language. I'm not gonna take that risk. I don't wanna work with those people. So let me talk to you about what integrity is. Integrity is partially, it's tangible. It is, do we religiously double and triple check our work? Do we test our final product, right? It's logistical. There's that aspect of responsibility that we accept and that we perform. The customers always ask, is he reliable? That's one of the big questions that every customer is asking every contractor. So I'm like 3.5 years into the trade. I'm the lead man remodeling, just the electrical wiring for a high-end kitchen remodel, $125,000, give or take. And the situation is this, coming out of the main electrical panel was a 2-wire plus ground. That wire was too short to feed the range on a 60-amp breaker. And so I extended the wire from the crawl space to the new range location with a 3-wire plus ground. The color coding doesn't match up perfectly from a 2-wire to a 3-wire. And so on the finish out, the gremlins all show up on the finish out. Rough ends look just fine until you start putting it all together and you have to plug in its appliances. So one, I failed to test properly. Two, my rough end self did not communicate effectively with my finish out self. I didn't take photos and I didn't make proper notes. And so what happens is I've got a $125,000 kitchen remodel. I've got an extremely intense and anal general contractor. We've got a brand new stainless steel range. It comes with a price tag of about $2,600. And I've got a lead man who's making like $1,650 an hour responsible for this project. I turn on the breaker and I hear this loud humming noise. And then suddenly the flash comes from the kitchen, loud pop. I go running back to the breaker. It's totally too late. I shut off the breaker. I walk into the kitchen and there's scorch marks on this stainless steel range. I'm undone. I have a choice to make. What do I do? Do the right thing. I call it the general contractor. I've seen this general contractor already on this job chew people's head off, rip them right off. So I called the general contractor and I said, hey, I just want you to know before I describe the situation, I'm good for it. We're gonna clean up the mess. This is what has happened. I just blew up your brand new stainless steel range. That comes with a $2,600 price tag. And I wanted you to know that I'm aware and I'm gonna fix it. He was so calm. He was like the just incredible, the impeccable gentleman. And he said to me, you know what? I understand. And you're in luck because appliance repair is coming out tomorrow because they got to look at the fridge. So I'm going to have them check that out too. Turns out $95 later and a step down transformer and I'm in the clear and they didn't even make me pay for it. I tried and they're like, no, we just appreciate your integrity. Guess what? 10.5 years later, I'm still working for that general contractor. I'm still working for that customer because I cleaned up the mess because I failed at competency, but I demonstrated something that was more important, and that's integrity.